One of the most exciting brands of cars is Audi. And you remember last week we were in the S4 Coupe. Well, this week I got a real treat for you. We're going to go into the new S5 Cabriolet convertible, all coming up right now on Road Trip.
Our new Audi S5 Cabriolet. This car, and I'm convinced that you will agree with me in just 1 minute, this car is a real eye-catcher. Its classic and elegant soft top disappears within 15 seconds, and its interior space and versatility make it absolutely ideal for practical use. When it comes to efficiency, the highly efficient engines, the automatic start-stop, the onboard computer with its efficiency programs, and our S-tronic double-clutch gearbox make it a new benchmark in this segment, in celebration of our 100th anniversary. I can assure you that we made a lot of phone calls to be able to present our new S5 Cabriolet with a today's one-of-a-kind team inside it. Here it is. And ladies and gentlemen, please extend a warm welcome to Willy Sagnol from FC Bayern Munich. Hi, Willy. Good to see you. Wes Brown from Manchester United. Gennaro Gattuso from AC Milan. And Carlos Bianchi from Boca Juniors, one of Argentina's most successful soccer teams. Bienvenidos. Wes, real quick question. What do you think about this beauty here?
Yeah, it's a very nice car, as you can see. If I was to have one, I'd surely drive it in Manchester.
Well, I'm excited because I'm standing right next to the product manager for Audi S3, 4, and 5. Carter Bacco. Carter, welcome to Road Trip.
Thanks so much.
So talk us around the new S5 Cabriolet.
Well, here in Sonoma, we're debuting the Audi S5 Cabriolet. All of our S models have sort of a familiar theme. There's a very aggressive front bumper design as well as rear. The grille design is always a platinum optic like this with chrome vertical strips. Then we have aluminum touches that are also signatures to our S models that you see here. Diffuser blades on the front and rear diffuser, and those complement the aluminum optic mirror housings that are on the doors. So again, just a few areas that tie the S models all together design-wise.
Carter, let's go to the back of the car.
Sure.
Every convertible always, to me, is judged by trunk space as well as the other features.
Sure.
Let's take a look inside the trunk.
All right. The S5 Cabriolet and its sister, the A5 Cabriolet, offer best-in-class trunk capacity.
Very.
And
nice.
The thing that enables that is our acoustic folding soft-top design. Instead of going with a retractable hardtop, we've been able to preserve the utility of a Cabriolet, because you want four adults and their stuff, not just the four people. So even with the top down, we have the most cargo space of any other vehicle in this segment.
Let's show them the rear folding down seats.
And that's one of the magical features of this Cabriolet, because no other Cabriolet has this feature where you pull this lever and the rear seat backs fold just like in a coupe or just like in a sedan. And they're split 50-50, so you can take three adults and another long object, whether it's skis or something else, if you're going up to Tahoe. It comes standard on these 19-inch wheels. There's one optional design that's still a 19, but large wheels, wide rubber for all of the grip to put these 330 horses on the ground.
You know, every time my dad gets into a convertible, he's always reaching around and trying to find the seatbelt. Show us what you've got in the
Absolutely. Well, once you get in the car and you have a seat, you'll find that this surrounding element around the seatbelt will actually reach out and give you the seatbelt.
Really?
Watch. So when we start the car, the first thing that happens is the seatbelt presenter brings us the belt. So you're not reaching over yourself to get to the seatbelt. And here's the other benefit of that is in cars that don't have this, you end up with a seatbelt that's kind of, it's sort of tethered to the seat here. And you want to put somebody in the back seat. How do you do that?
I've strangled many small children doing
exactly.
It.
So this way it always keeps it out of the way, but as soon as you need it, it hands it to you. So another just totally Audi solution. And the other thing that really points to the fact that this is an Audi and that we really pay attention to details like that is you'll notice that there is not a single antenna visible on the exterior of this car.
You're right.
The satellite radio for Sirius, the navigation GPS antenna, because it's concealed underneath the tonneau cover.
Yeah.
The tonneau cover is a composite that allows the signals to still get through, but they're all hidden underneath. But just because it's an Audi, it's beautiful, we don't want to destroy the top-down lines with something ungainly as an antenna.
Beautiful.
So, small details that really make a difference.
I should say. Oh, we got to get in and drive.
All right,
you know,
let's go for a ride.
Let's do it. Let's do it. So, Carter, the Cabriolet, there are three models.
Yeah, Audi's new Cabriolet family, the A5 Cab, has two A-family models. And it also has this car we're driving, the S model. So the A5 Cabriolet is available with Audi's absolutely wonderful turbo four-cylinder 2-liter engine. And this car is available as a front-wheel drive with a Multitronic transmission or quattro all-wheel drive with a Tiptronic transmission. And then the top of the three models is the S5, this car that we're driving, with the 3-liter supercharged V6 engine.
Quite an engine.
Yeah, it's a fast ride.
I mean, it's interesting that an engine can lose a little bit of horsepower but gain torque.
Oh,
and that's what you've done in the last year.
Absolutely. We've come out with an engine that, compared to the old S4 Cabriolet, we're just a small bit down on horsepower. The torque is about the same, but because it's a lighter weight powertrain and it's a more advanced chassis, we're able to achieve higher acceleration numbers and better driving dynamics.
Driving dynamics, that is really a key to Audis. How would you describe this S5?
Well, this S5, because it's intended to be the highest performance Audi Cabriolet, it features a sport-tuned suspension that's still compliant enough for most convertible drivers to enjoy driving around the city. But when you really get into the twisty roads, the suspension firms up and delivers. And you couple that to the new 3-liter supercharged V6, and you just really have a car that's a rocket in a straight line, but also one that handles in a very agile way with the quattro all-wheel drive system once you get on the twisty roads.
And once you need to stop, you better have some good brakes for those 18-inch wheels.
Yeah, the S5 models have an upgraded braking system that definitely befits the higher performance potential of this car. So, it has a larger set of brake rotors up front and ventilated rotors in the rear that allow you to bring this car to an absolutely abrupt stop should you need to.
Convertibles have always been weak in the rigidity type of area. How does the S5 rank?
You know, any convertible is an engineering challenge because when you take the roof out, you're taking away one of the key strength areas of a car.
Right.
However, we're starting with Audi's new B8 modular longitudinal platform, the same one that underpins the new Audi A4, the Q5, as well as the S5 Coupe. And this platform is incredibly rigid to begin with. So once you start chopping the roof on it, it's a great place to start. Now, we obviously have to add sill reinforcements, floor pan reinforcements, to sort of help replace some of that rigidity that you lost when you took off the roof. But because we're starting from such a strong, the modular longitudinal platform, because it's such a strong place to start, we don't have to work near as hard to make this Cabrio a very rigid car, minimal cowl shake, minimal flex when you put it through its paces.
It feels real solid, just extremely solid. When you say longitudinal, that means horizontal?
Our longitudinal platform is tied to, it's named because of the way the engine is mounted in the car.
Oh.
We have some vehicles that have a transverse mounted engine. This car has a longitudinal mounted engine, which means that the crankshaft is in line with the drive shaft. So that's why we call it the longitudinal platform.
If cars are your thing, if you're a gearhead, if you're buying a new car, all you need to know is the AutoChannel.com. With somewhere in the neighborhood of a million pages of content, the AutoChannel.com is the only automotive website you'll ever need to visit. Looking for the latest news in motorsports? Want to know what the hot new prototype was at the Detroit Auto Show? You'll know by going to the AutoChannel.com. The AutoChannel.com, your one-stop automotive website.
Tell us a bit about Drive Select.
Audi Drive Select is a feature that we launched last year on the A4. It's also available on the A5 and S5 families. It's a system that has no equal in the market today because it features an adaptive suspension system that is continuously adjusting the dampers to match the road conditions and your driving style. And it also features a dynamic steering system that's not only varying the weight of the steering feel, but it's also varying the ratio that it's connected to the front wheels at. So at parking lot speeds, it's a very fast ratio so that you don't have to turn so many locks. But when you get on the interstate, the ratio becomes much more direct so that the car is more stable at high speeds. And then the final component is that it adjusts the throttle tip in, the transmission shift points in the automatic transmission, and really allows you to customize the feel of the car. And it's controlled through an easy set of buttons on the dash that have comfort mode for the most comfortable ride, dynamic mode for the most sporty, or the best feature is called individual, which allows you to go into the MMI system and individually select each of those hardware parameters for the way you want it to feel. So maybe you like a more compliant suspension, but you love the direct dynamic feel of the steering. You can go set up that combination and it'll call up your profile whenever you're in the car.
That's terrific. And you can store more than one profile. So my wife could have a profile and I could have a profile.
There's only one profile that's in the individual, but it's always easily changeable. And then on the S model, you get one more piece of hardware, and that's the torque vectoring rear differential. We call it Quattro Sport, or Quattro with the Sport's rear diff. Mm. And that is a system that is allowing you to take the torque that's going to the rear axle and dynamically vary it from left to right, depending on what the driving conditions are.
That's amazing.
So that when you go around a corner, it will overdrive the outside rear wheel in order to steer the car from the rear. Absolutely wonderful technology.
Didn't that used to be done by the opposite, by braking one of the wheels?
Yeah, and that's definitely the old way of doing things. We're actively applying more torque to the outside rear wheel in order to steer the car from the rear.
Wow.
And that's eliminating understeer and making the car really agile. And in an S5 Cabriolet in Sonoma with the beautiful twisty roads we have here, this is, it's a great, great solution.
And I imagine that it probably helps you a lot in wet weather too.
Well, it does, because the torque sensing rear differential is tied to the ESP program of the car. So it can either act to make the car more agile, or it can act to make the car more stable. So it has a dual personality.
Now, I've heard that the convertible mechanism can work at 25, 30 miles an hour.
Yeah, absolutely. And because we're using a folding soft top and not a retractable hard top, that makes us the only car that you can fold the top at 30 miles an hour while you're in motion. On top of that, it's the fastest folding top in the segment at 15 seconds.
To some people, cars and trucks are everything. To others, they're just transportation. Whatever your interest level is, you'll find more at theautochannel.com. The Auto Channel has a million pages of content. No, I don't mean a million pages. I mean a million pages, including thousands of videos. And the Auto Channel has dozens of searchable databases with the latest new and used pricing information. And it's all free. Theautochannel.com. There's nothing else like it. We'll be right back.
starter, during the winter, let's say that I'm one of these tough guys who likes to put the top down when there's cold air. The Cabriolet can give me, can warm up my neck, can't it?
That's right, it absolutely can. The we have an optional seat that's available in the A5 Cabriolet or the S5 Cabriolet. It features cooling in the perforated leather, but it also has a vent that's located right behind your neck. And it literally blows warm air out at neck level so that it really extends top-down motoring season into the colder months. Like into October, you can continue to have the top down and enjoy that open feel with a nice cozy bit of warmth around you.
Yeah.
So it's a really cool seating technology.
I hope it has a sensor for when your head starts dropping forward because you're getting so sleepy.
Indeed, indeed. But it's it just makes it a nice cozy autumn convertible feel.
Yeah.
So you don't have to you don't have to turn it back into a coupe.
Yeah. You also have a removable windshield.
A wind block. Yeah.
Wind block.
Yeah, in the trunk we don't have it up on this car. At these speeds, we don't need it that much. But
yeah,
when you're cruising at high speed, like interstate speed, it's always nice to be able to break some of this wind that's coming over the windscreen and then circulating in the back seats.
Right.
So there's this windscreen that will assemble above the rear seats and pop up right here, and it blocks that wind buffeting so that you can just have normal conversations at interstate speed.
Yes.
Without a lot of wind blow.
And the ladies don't like their hair coming up.
Yeah, exactly.
Their face like
that's
that,
right. So
it's very important.
Yeah, indeed.
This could be a good spot. Let's take it down to about 25 miles an hour.
Okay.
And put the top up of all things.
All right. Well, you can do it up to 30 miles an hour in this car, and we'll go to about 20, 25. And, you know, say you're in stop and go traffic and you get ready to put the top up.
Yeah.
You know, all you do is push the slip button. And you still cruise along, you know, and in about 15 seconds, then the roof is fully closed above you, and there you have it. The tonneau cover goes back down into place, and it's as easy as this. So, and there's even a one-touch button to let the roof up. So, anyway, that's how that works. So, again, we're proud to be, you know, one of the only cars that'll do that on the road today.
If cars are your thing, if you're a gearhead, all you need to know is the AutoChannel.com. Looking for archival video of land speed racing on the Bonneville Salt Flats, Formula One at Nürburgring, drag racing at Pomona, Indy cars at Indy, or the Stockers at Daytona? The only website where you'll find it all is the AutoChannel.com. With somewhere in the neighborhood of a million pages of content, the AutoChannel.com is the only automotive website you'll ever need to visit. The AutoChannel.com.
A little acceleration in this car.
It's a lot of fun, and you have that great raspy V6 exhaust note that has a little bit of detonation on the upshifts that
you
notice.
It does. Yeah,
and very sporty sounding car. I mean, we paid as much attention to how it sounds as to how it drives. So not only do you get the feel of the acceleration, but you get the audible validation of what's going on.
Now, obviously, we don't have the top up right now, but you've done some work to make it acoustically quiet, which is important for a soft top.
Well, it is, and our soft top provides interior sound levels that are on par with the coupe version. And the way we achieve that is we have a multi-layer top that has numerous layers of high-density foam inside it, so that it's really sound isolating once you put the soft top up. We call that the Audi acoustic roof.
Okay. Now, when it comes to music and when it comes to sound, all I have to do is press the button in the center console. I've got a couple of slots that I can just put my chip in and away I go.
Yeah, well, we have numerous ways that you can take however you like to keep your media collection. You can interface it with this car. As you have already discovered, there are two SD card slots that if you like to keep your MP3s on little memory cards, or the most popular solution is the standard Audi music interface system. And that allows you to connect your iPod, put it in the glove box, and all of the control is handled through the MMI interface system, and it looks and works just like your iPod controls. So you don't have to keep reaching for your iPod and looking at the screen, because all of the song titles, everything shows up on the main center display screen here. So we have that available as well. And a player, a DVD player that'll play CDs, CDs with MP3s that will play DVDs. So numerous sources that you can put in.
Carter, thanks for the ride. Great trip.
The sideline of the sport pack is defined by this straight bonnet and an inclined windshield, a flat roof, and this fast acceleration in the back, which finishes it with this accent of a spoiler in the rear and gives a very sporty accent to this sideline, to the silhouette. In addition to these three lines which define the sport pack beauty, we have this very characteristic sideline of the window line, where you see in the rear this kind of elbow which pushes to the back on the rear and defines this very sporty and elegant at the same time sideline. These muscles are also very important.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great automotive information and entertainment, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.